The topic of our project is educational robotic platform. It is observed that students, especially school students, they are not exposed to robotics. And also in many colleges, students are not taught programming language. So we wanted to develop a product which will help the school students learn more about robotics. Another aim that we were focusing on was we wanted to build a cost-effective product, because currently whatever is available in the market is either expensive or not in the vicinity of the students. So we wanted to give them a platform using which they can learn programming, they can learn to code, they can also learn more about the hardware components, they'll get more exposure to build their own applications.
We have various ports as mentioned here. So the Raspberry Pi has a 40-pin header, but it is very difficult to program and it has many complex syntaxes as seen here. So it has many complex syntaxes to remember and to learn. So we wanted to simplify all of this. We wanted to simplify the main header part of it. That is why we divided the 40-pin headers into various ports. These are divided into 3-pin ports, 4-pin ports and 2-pin ports. And they are all throughout the robot, so they can plug and play their hardware components wherever they want according to their project. Here we have the smaller version of the same robot and it has all the same features as the big one. The only difference being that it does not have wheels and it does not have an inbuilt battery. And therefore we are able to reduce the cost by half in this robot. So again, our main motivation was to reach as many students as possible. And that is why we have a big robot for projects which they want to implement, moving projects or locomotive projects. And these ones will be static projects. The design of the robot has been done using 3D printed files. The entire robot, both the robots are 3D printed, and the lighting you see here, we wanted to reach school going students and college going students. And the idea we had was that the things they are attracted to most are gaming laptops and things that look appealing and attractive to them. So we implemented the RGB lightings inside our robot and made a translucent panel here so that it looks appealing from the outside as well. It doesn't look complicated. These are all the components, hardware components, which we will be including with our robot. These are just a few, but all Arduino compatible components which have these headers will be compatible with our robot as well. So Arduino compatible sensors are a standard in the market, and so if they are compatible with an Arduino, they'll be compatible with our robot. It's just simple plug and play. To control this LCD, for example, you will require eight wires, eight jumper cables and eight different connections on an Arduino or a Raspberry Pi. Here you just have to place it on the appropriate port number and specify the port number on the software and write whatever text you want to appear, and the software will do the rest for you. We have distance sensors like the ultrasonic sensor, which will sit on the 4-pin ports. Then we have sound sensor, which will sit on the 3-pin port. So the entire robot is plug and play. You just put your sensor, specify the port number and you do your program, and the robot will take care of the coding for you. No coding is required here. The software side, we have made a website. Our aim was to have it cross-platform and not dependent on any other dependencies. So all the user will require is a web browser and our robot. The user has to go to our hostname raspberrypi.local. And then he or she will be presented with three options: beginner, advanced and terminal. So the beginner option is for drag and drop programming, where you just have to specify the port number and what you want to do. The advanced option is for Python, because Raspberry Pi is programmed using Python. We have kept that option for engineers and people who know Python. They can do programming, they can program a robot using Python. And terminal is a general Linux terminal which is provided by the Raspberry Pi, so that will give the full power of the Raspberry Pi system to the user if they want to do something else. So I clicked on the beginner option. This will bring up the drag and drop programming which we have implemented. The base of our project is the Scratch and the Google Blockly projects, which are open source, but they are for software and for coding. We wanted to do something for hardware and robotics. So we have taken their software idea, whatever they had implemented for software, and added our own blocks for hardware. Here you can see there are blocks for all the hardware components which are provided by us. So there is a move forward block, move backward, move left, move right. You can drag and drop a block here to display text. There is a block to toggle LED, there is a block to read temperature from the temperature sensor, fire sensor, etc. Now, to do a basic program, I'm just going to start the GPIO server and then I'm going to drag a block, toggle LED. I've attached an LED on this port B1. So I'll specify the port as B1 and 0 is for off, 1 is for on. So when I execute this, the LED starts glowing on the robot. A normal Python program to do this, to glow an LED would have been around 10 lines, 10 to 12 lines. But here all the user has to do is drag and drop 2 blocks. Now to make a more complex program, let's say if I want to make the LED blink after every second. So here we are using the power of Scratch. They have already made the operators and the controls. So I'm just going to drag a loop. It's going to execute whatever I put inside this block, it's going to execute in a loop. I'll drag this toggle LED inside the loop. I'll wait for 1 second. Then I'll drag another block here to turn that LED off. And then again wait for 1 second. And if I execute this now, the LED starts blinking on and off after each and every second. So here we again can see the simplicity of the drag and drop GUI. Again, to do this, you would have required complex knowledge of looping and the syntax for wait, delay, etc. But here you just have to drag and drop 5 blocks and it's doing the blinking LED for you. I've attached an ultrasonic sensor on this port, which is the D1 port. So again, I just drag and drop the ultrasonic sensor block here and I'll display it on that LCD. When I execute this, the distance appears on this LCD. So this is the distance which it's the ultrasonic sensor is currently sensing. This is the obstacle. If my teammate takes the obstacle back, it will again change the distance to 14 centimeter now. The unit is centimeters. If he brings it closer, then it will change again. So I plug the fire sensor in the 3-pin port. This is the block for a fire sensor. It returns values of 1 if there is no fire and 0 if there is a fire. So first we'll see. So as soon as it senses a fire, it gives a value of 0. And now it again gives a 1. Now I implemented that in a program. So if it senses a value of 0, if it senses that there is a flame, it will display fire detected on this LCD. It will say alert fire detected. It will speak it out. And if there is nothing going on, then it will just say all okay. So right now it's saying all okay. Now my teammate put a fire, flame.
Fire detected.
Okay. So now it said fire detected. If we included, if there is a water pump sensor here, water pump motor. If we include that water pump motor here, then we can also make the program spray water on the fire. So that can be done by the students. This is one more program which is ready made, which I've already made. So here, if there is an obstacle, if the obstacle is too near, then it will go away from that obstacle. So the code here is again the same. It is displaying this distance on the LCD. If the distance is less than 10 centimeters between the obstacle and the robot, then it will say too near and it will move forward. So right now the distance is 13, so it's not moving. Now he took it forward. It said too near and it started moving. Also, we have the blocks for moving are here. So we have a move forward block. We have made the blocks by time. So if I want to move it for 2 seconds, I'll just say move forward for 2 seconds. Here I'll just say 1 second, move forward for 1 second, and it will move forward in 1 second. And the last thing I would like to show is that this robot works wirelessly. So obviously, because of the connection, the speed will be faster, but we just unplug the wire. So now, again, the process is the same. Start remote, drag and drop, move forward for 2 seconds. There is no wire attached. It will move forward. This is the advanced tab. Here, we wanted to give the users the option to interface with Python because Python is a very powerful programming language. So we have loaded up Jupyter Notebook. Jupyter Notebook is running on the robot, but it's being served over Wi-Fi on the user's laptop. We have made a library called EasyGPIO, and the EasyGPIO library works on the same principle as the Scratch programming language. We have made it very simple. Just provide the port number and the value you want. So here, I'll import the library first. The LED which was previously glowing, now I'll turn it off. So I executed the Python code to turn it off and the LED turned off. If I execute it to turn on, the LED turns back on. So we have similar functions for displaying to LCD fire sensor. Everything that is in Scratch is in Python also.